Wilkins trying to get his season started strong again. He is in the championship hunt and wants to be in 2019. Both cars leave well. Regal with a strong reaction time, but Sandy Wilkins picks up the Golden Wally here at the Gatornationals. Hey everybody, welcome to the NHRA Wally Park Studio East. We are back with more Skype conversations this week with some of our favorite professional and sportsman racers. And I have with me today 2019 Vortech Superchargers NHRA Top Sportsman World Champion, Sandy Wilkins. And Sandy, we got a couple things to talk about here, but the first thing I'm going to congratulate you on is winning the 2020 Baby Gator Nationals and being about the last guy in America to win a drag race. So that's kind of an odd feeling.
It is kind of an odd feeling to be the last guy to win a drag race. It's pretty awesome.
So talk to me a little bit about your 2019 championship campaign, because I know how much it meant to you. I know how close you would come in the past. And, you know, the top sportsman category is such a hotbed of competition with NHRA. So let's relive that 2019 season a little bit. And it did come down to the wire.
It did. It came down to the last race for us. We were able to win, which was fantastic. But there were still three events out west where guys could pass me, and it came down to a nail biter where Doug Crumlich had a very close race and was on the losing end, which benefited me, which was great for our season.
It was great for your season. You know, let's talk a little bit about Top Sportsman too, because basically outside of one championship, all the championships have gone to the Southeast. We got a lot of guys from down south that are big into this category. It's where that style of drag racing really started. And what's been your history in Top Sportsman before becoming a national champ?
Well, my first Top Sportsman race was in 1998 in a different series, and then we came to NHRA in 2003 and actually won the first the championship that first season in 2003, which was fantastic. And, you know, at that point, we're kind of hooked, and we had a very slow next decade, I'd say. And, you know, and then kind of picked it back up about 5 years ago with, you know, I've changed the program a little bit, changed cars, and definitely went the right direction with our program, and it's been really good over the last 5 years.
You are an engine builder by trade, so let's talk engines for a second here. What is the power plant in your Camaro that you drove to a world championship?
It's a 665 big block Chevy, nitrous application. It's about 1,370 horsepower, normally aspirated, and we have two nitrous systems and can run, you know, anywhere from 680s to 630s, and it gives us a lot of flexibility depending on track conditions and racetracks and what time of the year we're racing.
Obviously, we have basically every power adder under the sun involved in Top Sportsman these days: Roots blowers, centrifugal blowers, Vortech being the class sponsor for the national championship, and nitrous turbochargers as well out there. What makes you a dedicated nitrous racer? And, you know, I think everybody out there loves the fact that a nitrous guy is able to still win this championship. And why are you still hooked on nitrous?
That's a good way to put it. Hooked on nitrous, like a drug, right? I really like the flexibility with nitrous. So, you know, we have different combinations for different times of the year. So, I mean, if you'll look, sometimes we qualify near the top of the sheet, you know, in the 630 range, and sometimes we qualify in the 660 range, and sometimes in the 680 range. And that's what I like about the nitrous. It's easy for us to manage how fast we want to go and whether or not we want to be fast at the beginning of the run, fast towards the end of the run. It's it gives us lots of flexibility, and it's, you know, inexpensive to get started with nitrous. Now, at our level, you spend a lot on nitrous, but to get started, it's really inexpensive, and it's a good way to add power to your package.
Now, your better half, Michelle, I grew up in New England Dragway announcing her winning drag races, including races in Top Sportsman. She had a great Rick Jones-built Corvette that she won an IHRA national event with, maybe a couple, but I know at least one. And I believe she's itching to get back in a race car. So is this going to be a two-car dragster door slammer operation out of the Wilkins camp soon?
Yes. So she got back in the car at the Baby Gators this year and had a great time. And the very first thing she said when she got out of the car was, "I need to go faster." And So we're working on a plan. We had a plan for 2020, even though that has changed for not just us, everyone. And we'll get back to racing with the two car team as soon as we get going again.
Well, it's pretty great, and it's been great to see your success, your tenacity. Obviously, you wore the number two on the window of that car for a short while, and you're able to wear the number one with pride here in 2020. So, Sandy, I appreciate you taking the time, and you can go back to making horsepower for your customers there, man. I appreciate it.
Brian, thank you very much. Hope you guys stay safe and healthy.
You too, man. Thanks again. We'll be back with more from the East Coast NHRA Wally Park Studio with more conversations with more racers later this week.